We light the second candle, remembering the poverty of the Bethlehem manger and God's love. Lord Jesus, in love you became poor so we could be rich. Help us use the riches of your grace to love others as you love us. O King of all nations, Jesus Christ, only joy of every heart, come and save your people. Thanksgiving to Divine Mercy and the Blessed Mary, thanksgiving for favors received, thanksgiving for blessings received by Kenneth Rodericks, thanksgiving for Orlando Oliveira's surgery, peace in the home, birthday blessings for Daniel Pereira, Hazel Coelho, Noella Travas, Lorraine and Mel Roy, Warren Valadares, Andrew Candela, wedding anniversary blessings for Anthony and Teresa, good health and welfare of Joseph Nerona and family, Karen Oliveira, Lorraine Fernandez, Alanis Dias, Cassandra Baptista, Anthony Ra, Maquina Disa, and Zita D'Souza, good health and speedy recovery of Selvin Mendonca, thanksgiving for Crispin and Suel, souls of Reina and Edward Dos Remedios, Joseph Fernandez, Martha Fernandez, Jack and Odelia Fernandez, Philip and Connie Alfonso, Wilfred and Remy Gonzalez, Father E.B. Dias and Father Barjao and Brother Tort, Theoton, Philomena and Philip Coutinho, Cecilia Faria, Ignatius and Afra Matthews, Joseph Ligori and Agnello Matthews, Mari Gonzalez, Sylvie Castellino, and Raymond Hendricks, Mahindra Bar, Francis Fernandez, Diego Fernandez, and the souls of the Fernandez, Coutinho, and Carvalho families, the departed members of the Tixera Fernandez Menti and Ribello family, Monsignor Andrew Dias, Sister Euphrasia, Sister Valdemira, Peter Machado, Joel Dias, Daphne and Rock Pereira, and souls in purgatory. We also join those celebrating their birthdays and anniversaries as they give praise and thanks to God for the gift of life and relationships. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit,
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
As we begin the second week of Lent, we are reminded by John the Baptist of God's love for us. Gathered around the Eucharistic table, let us seek his blessings and pardon and forgiveness for all our sins. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault, therefore I ask the Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
merciful God, may no earthly undertaking hinder those who set out in haste to meet your Son, and may our learning of heavenly wisdom gain us admittance to his company, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
A reading from the prophet Isaiah. Comfort, comfort my people, says your God. Speak tenderly to Jerusalem and cry to her that her warfare is ended, that her iniquity is pardoned, that she has received from the Lord's hand double for all her sins. A voice cries, in the wilderness, prepare the way of the Lord. Make straight in the desert a highway for our God. Every valley shall be lifted up, and every mountain and hill be made low. The uneven ground shall become level, and the rough places a plain. And the glory of the Lord shall be revealed, and all flesh shall see it together. For the mouth of the Lord has spoken. Go on up to a high mountain, O Zion, herald of good news. Lift up your voice with strength, O Jerusalem, herald of good news. Lift it up, fear not. Say to the cities of Judah, behold your God. Behold, the Lord God comes with might, and his arm rules for him. Behold, his reward is with him, and his recompense before him. He will tend his flock like a shepherd. He will gather the lambs in his arms. He will carry them in his bosom and gently lead those that are with young. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let us see, O Lord, your mercy, and grant us your salvation. Let us see, O Lord, your mercy, and grant us your salvation. I will hear what the Lord has to say. He speaks of peace for his people. His hope is near to those who fear. His glory will reign in our land. Let us see, O Lord, your mercy, and grant us your salvation. Faithfulness and mercy have met. Justice and peace have embraced. Faithfulness shall spring from the earth, and justice look down from the heaven. Let us see, O Lord, your mercy, and grant us your salvation.
A reading from the second letter of Saint Peter. Do not overlook this fact, beloved, that the Lord one day is 1,000 years, and 1,000 years as one day. The Lord is not slow to fulfill his promise, as some count slowness, but is patient towards you, not wishing that you should perish, but that you should reach repentance. But the day of the Lord will come like a thief, and then the heavens will pass away with a roar, and the heavenly bodies will be burnt and dissolved, and the earth and the works that are done on it will be exposed. Since all these things and dust are thus to be dissolved, what sort of people ought you to be in lives of holiness and godliness, waiting for and hastening the coming of the day of God, because of which the heavens will be set on fire and dissolved, and the heavenly bodies will melt and they burn. But according to his promise, we are waiting for new heavens and a new earth in which righteousness dwells. Therefore, beloved, since you are waiting for these, be diligent to be found by him without a spot or blemish and at peace. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia, alleluia, he will not delay, so keep your lamps aglow. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. The beginning of the Gospel of Jesus Christ, the Son of God. As it is written in Isaiah the prophet, "Behold, I send my messenger before your face, who will prepare your way. The voice of one crying in the wilderness, 'Prepare the way of the Lord, make his path straight.'" John the Baptist appeared in the wilderness and proclaiming a baptism of repentance for the forgiveness of sins. And all the country of Judea and all Jerusalem were going out to him and were being baptized by him in the river Jordan, confessing their sins. Now John was clothed with camel's hair and wore a leather belt round his waist, and ate locusts and wild honey. And he preached, saying, "After me comes he who is mightier than I, the strap of whose sandals I am not worthy to stoop down and untie. I have baptized you with water, but he will baptize you with the Holy Spirit." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to God, Jesus.
There is an old Jewish story about a man called Isaac who went to his neighbor in order to borrow his donkey from him. As soon as Isaac made his request known, the neighbor frowned and said, "I'm so sorry, I cannot give you my donkey because I have already loaned him to someone else." He hardly said this that Isaac began to hear the braying of the donkey from the stable. So immediately he said, "How can you tell me that your donkey is loaned to someone else? I can hear him braying from the stable." The neighbor looked at Isaac and said, "My boy, whose voice do you believe in, mine or the donkey's?" Brothers and sisters, the liturgy today invites us to listen to valid voices. Right in the Gospel, we are hearing John the Baptist telling us about Jesus. And this voice of John the Baptist is a voice that calls for repentance, a voice that announces the good news of the coming of the Messiah, of Jesus, a voice that introduces him as someone who is going to baptize us with the Holy Spirit. And in all his teaching, we realize that John is preparing the people for this great event, the fulfillment of the promise. We often hear different types of voices in the world. These days, during the pandemic, we have been hearing various voices coming across to us in the social media or even in television, telling us different stories, creating a lot of depression. And even we hear the news of so many people succumbing to the virus. Then we hear news of scandals and scams. Then we listen to news about terrorism. And at the same time, the voices of these terrorists that talk about disturbing the peace. And these voices are telling us that if you want to be protected, if you want to be safe, then you have to resort to violence. In the same way, we hear various voices around us. Voices that discourage us in the family. Voices sometimes that are giving us abuse. Voices of rejection. Relationships are affected. So these voices that we keep hearing are voices that are part and parcel of our living in this world. But what do we do as Christians? It is important for us to understand that the voice of Jesus is the voice that brings the good news. We know this when he stood in the synagogue and he announced his manifesto. I have come to bring good news to the poor, liberty to captives, sight to the blind. And we find therefore his words very comforting, very reassuring. Of course, we also find him challenging us and confronting us. But what is important is that when we open our ears and listen to the voice of Jesus, the voice of God, then we also become messengers of Jesus in the world. Our voices begin to be heard. And this is a very serious responsibility. We look at the three protagonists of the readings of today. The prophet Isaiah is the voice that calls out to the people, reminding them of God's love, mercy, and compassion. Saint Paul is the voice that reminds the people of living holy and saintly lives, to be able to deal with the circumstances of the world. The voice of John the Baptist, reminding us of God's love and mercy promised to us in Jesus Christ. And therefore, in our own circumstances, in our families, in our places of work, in our communities, we are called to be voices that matter. And the reason is because we draw from the voice of Jesus, whom we keep our ears open to listen. What are his words of compassion, of healing, of joy, of peace? What is the good news that he is trying to deliver? And as soon as we internalize these words, as soon as we begin to reflect these words in our actions, the people around us are touched by this voice. They are drawn to Jesus. And this therefore becomes for us a responsibility that anything that we say and do is always the voice of God, the voice of Jesus. So whether it is to bring encouragement to members of our family, to bring healing to people in our community, to reach out to them, the vulnerable, the poor, the stranger, we are called to be the voice of Jesus in the world. As we begin the second week of Advent, let us focus on listening to the voice of Jesus through scripture, through our prayer. Let us also listen to the voice of Jesus sometimes from our own peers, from our family, from people of the community. And it is in the positivity of our actions that we allow people to listen to the voice of Jesus through us. Amen. We profess our faith together. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried and rose again on the third day in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. As we prepare ourselves for the Lord's coming in glory, let us surrender our needs to God, who is full of mercy and compassion. Our response is, Merciful Lord, hear our prayer. All together.
Merciful Lord, hear our prayer.
That Pope Francis, the bishops, priests, and religious may, like John the Baptist, help the faithful prepare the way for the Lord's coming through repentance and forgiveness. We pray to the Lord.
Merciful Lord, hear our prayer.
That those holding positions of authority in our world may always seek to be just and comforting towards the poor, the marginalized, and those who are vulnerable because of hate and other insecurities. We pray to the Lord.
Merciful Lord, hear our prayer.
That during this season of Advent, we may learn to love, forgive, and reach out in compassion as we prepare ourselves to worthily welcome our Lord. We pray to the Lord.
Merciful Lord, hear our prayer.
That all those affected due to the pandemic may be comforted by our God of mercy, faithfulness, and justice. We pray to the Lord.
Merciful Lord, hear our prayer.
That God may give ear to our personal needs, especially for the well-being of our farmers who are raising their voices against injustice. We pray to the Lord.
Merciful God, hear our prayer. Lord, come to our aid as we place our trust in your comforting providence. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen.
We offer you, O Lord divine, our humble gifts of bread and wine. We place them on your altar, Lord, today. Make them worthy of your love. Send your blessings from above. Sanctify these gifts, O Lord, we pray. Oh,
and since we have no merits to plead our cause, come we pray to our rescue with the protection of your mercy. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Jesus Christ. For he assumed at his first coming the lowliness of human flesh, and so fulfilled the design you formed long ago, and opened for us the way to eternal salvation. That when he comes again in glory and majesty, and all is at last made manifest, we who watch for that day may inherit the great promise in which now we dare to hope. And so with the angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord.
these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread
and drink this cup,
we proclaim your death, O Lord,
until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Oswald our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, your power, and glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, where you live forever and ever." The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other a sign of peace. Peace be with you. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Our act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at me spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you.
Wholly to you.
Never permit me,
never permit
to be separated from you.
Amen.
Let us pray. Loving Father, we thank you and praise you for the gift of this Eucharist we have celebrated. We thank you for the gift of our faculties that help us understand you and also give us the strength to proclaim you in our words and actions. Help us, like John the Baptist, to be the voice of Jesus in the world. May each and every word that we utter bring peace and joy and mercy. Strengthen us, O Lord, in our journey that we make through life as we listen to different voices, most often negative, sometimes positive. May we always make that positive difference in the world as we encourage people, that we heal them, that we bring them joy. May this Eucharist nourish us and strengthen us. And may you always protect us from all harm. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord. As you are aware, since last Sunday, our church has been open for the physical celebration of the Eucharist. We have been following a certain method. The communities are given the dates in advance, and you are expected to register your names with the parish pastoral council members. We need to have this discipline in place because the number of seats available after making arrangements for social distancing is about 90. This entire week has gone by well. People have been coming to church, and I know that they have felt the joy of receiving Jesus in Holy Communion. The new list is out, and I'm sure that you would love to participate in the celebration of the Eucharist, but please remember to register your name with the parish pastoral counselor so that there is no difficulty when you come to church. We now will continue with the round of offering of masses for the month of January, that is the online masses. The same procedure. There is a box that is placed outside the church office, and we also have the online reception of masses. But once again, I request you, these are only two masses per family. I'm sorry to say this, but if there are more masses, then we will only take the first two, because the number becomes too much, and then many people do not get the opportunity to have their masses offered. So kindly cooperate with us. The last date for masses for the month of Jan is the 23rd of December. Either register your names for mass or online, the offering, or for that matter, drop the intentions in the box that is outside the church office. Once again, thank you very much for cooperating with us, and we do hope and pray in the days that go by, we will be able to have better participation in the Eucharist, especially as Christmas draws near. Let us pray. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May the blessings of Almighty God, the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit descend upon you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
Go in peace and celebrate the gospel with your lives.
Thanks be to God.
Jesus come, Jesus come, Jesus come. Say to us, I'm the one who wish to come. He will come just when you feel he'll never come. He will come just when you think he is gone. He'll be there just when you find he's elsewhere. Please don't be late, stay awake, let him come. Jesus come,
Jesus come, Jesus come.
Say to us, I'm the one who wish to come.
Jesus come,
Jesus come, Jesus come.
Say to us, I'm the one who wish to come.